you are in Yola, Nigeria, gather around for an exclusive behind-the-scenes look into the lives of two entrepreneurs shaping the cultural and entertainment landscape in Northeast Nigeria. These CEOs are not just young, smart and good-looking, they're also brothers. They run the only cinema in Northeast Nigeria at the moment and a fine dining restaurant where the high and mighty come to dine. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Faisal and Fahad, the founders of Fasnet Cinema and Restaurant.
Welcome to Fasnet. First things first.
How old are you guys?
Since we're prepared to give them our private.
We are young.
Obviously, you are young. Okay. Yes.
Okay. Under 30.
Under 30. Amazing. Okay, that works. We are all under 30 here. Yeah. I love that. Okay, yeah, nice one.
This is one of the most beautiful restaurants in Yola, Nigeria.
Thank you very much.
So, with no further ado, tell us, how did you do this?
it's a long,
I'm sure,
well, a long story, but we'll try to keep it short.
So, you know, when we opened the cinema offices in 2021, our hallway was also a restaurant. You understand? We're like a small restaurant, like a mini restaurant, you understand, for all these pastries and even with food, actually. But it was more of our pastries shawarma because of the space, you understand? So, as time goes on, you understand, during the year, you understand, we came to realize that the people actually loved our food. Is amazing, by the way.
Exactly.
So people loved our food, you understand, and the space wasn't enough, especially during festive periods. You understand, many people come will be like, there's no space to sit. You understand, no seats available, and you know the space is a bit narrow. So for a family member that would like to, a family man that would like to come with his with his family,
they
understand,
feel
exactly, they don't feel comfortable because you'll be walking past them. Exactly. So and this space was here, you understand, it was empty, there was nothing, you understand. At first wanted to go into supermarket business, you understand, but later I decided that since that place is tied up, you understand, why not just venture and expand it and venture full into the restaurant business, understand. So that's when we started going into the works of getting in touch with people who are consultant, people that will come and give us the designs and everything, understand. But for the designs, actually, you'll be surprised, it was me and him that did it.
I don't doubt.
From the lightnings and everything, the panels, everything.
The colors, the color, everything.
It was our idea, pitching the idea, and it became into a reality.
So what you guys are telling me right now is that this entire beautiful restaurant started off from a small hallway upstairs. Incredible. So how long? How long was the hallway? How long did you run the hallway for?
Almost two years.
And that gave back to this.
Exactly.
You know, has it been a good transition from the
incredibly smooth?
I love that.
Because once the people here learned that we've opened and expanded this, you understand?
Exactly.
It was actually like, how will I say, a dream come true for them, you understand? Because it was just like I said it before, our food is amazing, you understand? And with the aesthetics here, it made it complement, it just matched everything, the fitting was just perfect. So that's it. So it was a smooth decision for us.
Mentioned food right now. What makes your food special?
You know, we have some of the I would say some of the best chefs here in Nigeria. You understand? In the whole of Yola, I'm very sure of that. We're one of the best, some of the best in Nigeria. You understand? So we do intercontinental. You know, it's an intercontinental restaurant. We have intercontinental meals. We have our local meals as well. Understand? And we also try to venture into getting some of this. Like, and we have Chinese dishes. Let me just be specific. We have Indian cuisines. We have Singaporean dishes. We also have even Mexican and Asian dishes. We have seafood as well. So that's how good some of the things we have.
Okay, that's good to hear. What's your number one? What's Fasnet's signature dish?
Two or three, understand?
Yeah,
Singaporeans, understand? Singapore. I will do the rice, and then I'll also go into the pasta as well. Mm-hmm. We have Singapore rice, mm-hmm. understand? It comes with a side dish of chicken and chili sauce, exactly. Understand?
Yes.
We have a Chinese rice. You all need to try our Chinese rice, by the way. It's incredible.
Yeah.
We have Chinese rice, and then the last, we also have biryani. We have the best biryani here in Yola.
Yes.
The best. I'm 100% sure of that. That there's no place you can get the best biryani other than Fasnet. I'm 100% sure of that.
100%.
And then for pastas, we have Chinese vegetarian pasta. Even from the look of it, you'll feel, I'm already here. So that's how good our Chinese vegetarian is. We have Chinese vegetarian. We have the most incredible out of all, stir-fried.
Stir fried pasta.
Can come in chicken?
It can come in choice of chicken or beef.
Understand? So, whichever. Absolutely
perfect. Perfect.
It's good.
I can community 100%.
Anyway, inside. Try a pasta. Try a stir fried.
You need to
try. You'll love it. It's absolutely amazing.
You'll love it.
Yeah. So, this side, they're saying, then we also have Alfredo, you understand, for people that like creamy pastas and all that, you can go for Alfredo. We have bolognese and so on and so many other stuff.
You guys are making me hungry already. Chop life for Dubai. Anything you want, girl, I go buy. You didn't put me for high tension. This one of my confession. I used to believe we were burning on the edge of something beautiful. Something beautiful.
I don't even skip about the shawarma
part. I'm wondering, even in the comment section, where this is me, I'm about shawarma. Pizza as well. So,
pizza as well.
Try shawarma.
Lovely.
And the burger as well. Don't forget about the
burger.
And the price. Perfect. Amazing.
Perfect.
When you were growing up,
did
you ever see yourselves as running a restaurant business?
No.
No.
That's the truth of the matter.
I've never pictured myself.
But I came to develop the passion for it. Well, even that time we were trying to open the cinema, when they were trying to bring in the concept of adding an eatery, mini eatery.
Yeah.
I was not really moved with selling rice, selling this, about the restaurant, you know?
Yeah.
Surprisingly, when we kick-started it, I kind of start having passion, you know, in the area as well. That was even what made us, let's go downstairs. Yeah. Since we have space downstairs, like I told you initially, exactly, the space downstairs, we plan it for supermarket and other this thing. But because of the, the result we're having upstairs, and the demand and then the driven passion, let's expand it downstairs. That's how it came to be with our touches.
I can cook, right?
Yeah, all of us here. I can cook for you.
Is it like? I can cook a lot.
I can cook stir fried pasta. I can cook so many dishes. You'll be surprised. Mm-hmm. And I'm also a very, very good mixologist. Mm-hmm. You'll be surprised.
You'll be surprised. Fasnet Cinema and Restaurant.
The both of you can cook.
Yeah. Sure.
What's your signature? What dish do you cook best? Individually.
I can make I wouldn't say there's a specific or a particular dish that I can cook, I can cook so many amazing things. That's just the fact, you understand? But I can't pinpoint one because I make amazing sandwiches, you understand? I can make Philadelphia sandwich. I can make club chicken sandwiches, you understand? These are just pastries that I'm just mentioning. Come to the side of the main dishes, you understand? I can cook, just like I said, I can cook stir-fried pasta. I can cook Chinese rice, you understand? I can cook jollof as well, you understand? And I can cook amazing smoky jollof, just to be precise, you understand? So, smoky jollof, I can cook that one as well. Then, I can also make two, you'll be surprised. I can make two, you understand? I can make two. I can also make for drinks, you understand? I think I don't want to brag or something, but I believe everything on that menu, on our menu,
exactly.
I can make it.
Exactly. So that's what I was telling you earlier. You know, yeah. What when you want to do something, make sure that passion,
that passion
is there.
Is there.
So most of these dishes, we learn it on the
job.
Exactly. As they're doing it, you are paying attention to it.
I enter the kitchen, I see what they are doing.
Exactly.
Whatever it is,
okay, what makes this? What makes this?
And believe me, I have so much interest and passion for making or for cooking food now. So
about let's say. Sure. I'm pretty sure about like I can make about more than 70% of the menu, things on the menu.
Yeah.
Exactly. From the mocktails, from the pastas, the pastries, everything. I can do tacos. I prepare my salsa sauce. Oh my God! You have to test my tacos.
I wish
I can bake my burger bread. Mm. Everything.
But regardless, we have chance for that.
But regardless,
these are
things actually
at our leisure time.
At my leisure,
exactly.
Leisure
time.
Yeah,
that.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Understood.
Yeah.
What's your most selling dish at the moment?
We have Chinese rice. We have Singapore rice,
stir fried beef pasta,
exactly. Or chicken pasta as well.
Yeah.
We also have Bolognese is also moving.
Yeah.
We have biryani, just like I mentioned, biryani. We also have mandi as well, but you know, for it's not everybody that knows mandi. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lamb dish. Understand? It's an Indian dish. Understand? That is that's been prepared with lamb. Understand? So if you are not interested, you might not really like it, but it's good.
Mm-hmm.
It's really good. So we also have our spicy beef noodles. Very good.
Yeah.
Very, very good. You need to try that one as well. Our Fasnet rice,
yeah.
Mexican rice.
Yeah.
I think there was an actor that came here.
Mr. Emeka, the president of Actors Guild Association.
You guys can check it on our Instagram page.
Yeah.
We are having Mexican rice.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like I'm in Mexico.
So there are food that when you see them, you are just saying football, it's not football, it's not camera. It's happening at where?
Fasnet.
Cinema and restaurant.
Adamawa
State. Here in Yola, Adamawa State.
Exactly.
I can't believe it. Oh my God.
You're welcome.
Okay. This is the presidential outing in Yola, Adamawa State. We're enjoying Fasnet cinemas and restaurants.
Yes, sir.
Well, I am eating Mexican rice with all the distance and right here at Fasnet Restaurant and Cinema. In Yola, Adamawa State. This is the best place to be because I feel like I'm in Mexico now.
I know mommy's not here right now, and we don't know why. We fear how we feel inside. It may seem a little crazy, pretty baby, but I promise mama's gonna be alright.
That's how good it is.
You need to try that.
It's really good.
Our pizza, burger, mocktails, our milkshake as well. I also have started. We do tandoori wings. We have so many things. We have cheese bread.
Yes.
So many varieties, believe me. Barbecue wings. We also have cheese sausage rolls. We have so many varieties on the menu. Something that even my mind can skip at the time.
Tells me one thing.
Yeah.
All this menu that you're calling.
Yeah.
It tells me that your regular customers, obviously,
mm-hmm.
you know, are people who have a wide
array.
Exactly. Yes.
A lot.
Yes.
So they come. They obviously had many things. They're well traveled.
Exactly. They know what they are ordering. Exactly. Yes.
All right. So, how do you sustain that? How do you keep them coming back?
Yeah, we usually twist with the dishes from time to time a bit.
Mm.
Yeah. We try to incorporate
new IFMs, new dishes.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Sometimes we try to, like, we we play around, you know, with the exactly.
We have just out in almost, I think, 2-3 months.
Yeah.
After 2-3 months, you understand?
Yeah.
Even right now, I mean, it's deep for
Yeah.
You understand? We better mean after 3 months, so that we'll keep them and try to understand.
Exactly.
At least something to keep on bringing them every 3 months or later, man.
Yes.
Regardless of how the disease will add, we still add. We still like find a way to add different varieties.
Exactly.
So that even if you come today, tomorrow if you come, you might say a different time. We'll try to try something different.
Exactly.
So and they're all good. I believe.
Yeah.
All good.
Okay, good. Can you tell us some of your guests? You know, what kind of guests come here?
We have Alini, the famous managing director. He's now the managing director of Nigerian Food Corporation.
He's
actually sat down there.
We actually have a dinner with him.
We have pineapple rice. We have just like I mentioned, the president of Nigerian Association of Nigeria, Mr. Emeka Rowlands. With so many other actors as well. We have what is his name? DJ Abba.
Yes,
okay. The famous artist, you understand? Our Hausa,
popular rappers,
and other artists.
Exactly.
So many of them actually.
Many of them.
But we don't want to bring
for privacy. For privacy. Exactly.
This is creme de la creme. Creme de la creme.
Exactly.
I love that. Okay, so let's talk about price. Okay. So what's your most expensive dish here?
I think our most expensive is our grilled fish.
Grilled fish.
You understand?
Yeah.
Okay. You know they say feed the body.
That works the money.
So it's actually feed the body that works the
money. That works the money.
You in my next time Kim go down for you.
Nice
it's
one.
Actually a big platter of fish, you understand? A very big platter of fish.
Yeah.
It comes with fries, you understand? With also the sauce, with cucumber, very various veggies, you understand, on top of it. For people that like veggies as well, you understand? So it's one of our most expensive dish, you understand? Because it's under grills, you understand? It's around 15,000 as well. But then we also have under our main dishes, I think the most expensive is 10,000, which is Fasnet rice, you understand? It's our rice, you understand? It comes with seasonal veggies, you understand? Broccoli, cauliflower, the rice, you understand?
And
all this Chinese cabbage, and it comes with it, and then it comes with a grilled chicken as well. Then our Singaporean rice, also our all
the Singapore rice,
We try to keep it balanced, even for the economy, you understand, due to this inflation and everything, but we also try to keep it balanced. And our portions are enormous.
Generous.
Very generous.
And I think in terms of the keeping it balanced, you guys are doing a fantastic job because relative to other places, like in Abuja, for example, if you're talking about all these dishes in Abuja, no freaking way. You know, so good job.
We try as much as possible, you know, to keep it balanced. Even though, you know, it's Yola, most of the ingredients we need, some of them we might not find it here. But that's one of the challenges we usually have. And sometimes, even if you do get them, because of the monopoly of the market, maybe you find out there is actually one vendor that is bringing that type of ingredient in the whole of Yola. So you try to like monopolize the market. Exactly. Those are some of the challenges. And then the general Nigerian economy. We hope it gets better.
I'm sure. How do you navigate power? Because there's always light here.
We
have our inverter.
Exactly.
That we tend to incorporate as well. And also our standby generator. This band here of it, we're also on band A.
Band A.
Elite band.
You said that. I didn't know. That's how we are able
to,
it's not easy. By they usually pay a heavy amount. I don't want to give you a specific figure, but let's just say between the range of 1 million.
That's what we spend on power. We're just electricity, excluding like diesel cost, you know. like an inverter as well, because you have to be renewing the batteries and all. You get what I'm saying? This is just electricity.
Why this?
1 million above.
I don't want to call it specific.
But
that high?
Yeah, it's that high.
Per year?
Per month. Before the increase of the tariff, it was below that.
It was below that actually. But
when they increase the tariff, you know, this place, it's a very lovely environment.
You don't like it.
So AC has to be on almost all the time.
Exactly.
Right? The environment has to be convenient for our customers.
Exactly.
So there's always light, there's always AC on, you understand? And everything, including the equipment, the gadgets, and also the tools that we have.
The cinema upstairs
that we're going to in just a minute. Okay, wait until you see it.
so that's how it is incredible.
Okay, so what advice would you give to upcoming entrepreneurs who are looking to go into the hospitality business? No, restaurant specifically, you know,
have passion for it,
and also try to know, you know, about the business. Try to have like knowledge about it. Do your own research, well enough research, like well thought research about the whole, you know, whole aspect of it.
I think it will help you a lot.
And if by any chance, don't try to do things alone. Try to find partners. Like-minded people.
Amazing.
Yes.
Just like your brother.
Exactly. Yes. Okay. There are some things I'm not shy of. There are some ideas. You suggest them to me that I don't have. You get what I'm saying? And they are really good, bright ideas.
Nice.
And I as well, I can. So we work hand in hand. And that what makes it, you know, exactly. Yes. Yes. So don't try to, if you can, don't try to do things alone. You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
Seek like-minded people
okay.
that have similar passion.
Beautiful.
Yes. Wow. If you get the right team, the right set of people, you can make it work.
I love that. Yes. Speaking of team, how many people, how many staff do you have here?
We bought the restaurant and cinema.
What's your peak days in the week? And what's your peak day, peak hours in the day?
Okay.
Yes.
Peak days during the week, usually weekends.
Weekend.
Yeah. Friday, Saturday, Sunday are usually the peak days. And then peak hours, anytime from three, four, five, up to closing. Exactly. It's usually busy. Okay. There's a lot of traffic.
Let's assume I have a birthday celebration or a little party I want to get together.
Yeah.
I want to throw here.
Yeah.
How much will it cost me to rent this space?
For the whole place or for a table? Because it depends.
For the whole place or just for a table?
For a table. Because some people will just like a table for two.
And then other customers can still.
For a table of two. Depends on your budget, understand? We have different packages for it, understand? We have the one for the normal slice cake and then the written happy birthday.
Exactly. My wife, for instance, or our husband, depends on you guys. We do that.
And then also with the fireworks, understand?
Everything.
If you want, we can have like a clip for you, a video clip, so that you guys can also send it to each other or send it to your family members. And also, we also tend to make a team deco table. Depending on the event you're having,
whether birthday or you want to have a romantic night out, exactly, with candles and all.
I love that. Who does that? Do you have someone in house?
We usually do, he takes the video. Yes.
Wow, no, that's remarkable actually. You know, so these CEOs, are very hands
on. Very handy. Don't be surprised. you come and meet me, you know? Decorating, yeah.
They're in the kitchen and they're on the seven floors. I love it.
Yeah.
You know, and I think it's one of the things I like the best about you, because, you know, most times people who are in your position tend to adopt a higher supervisory role. Why do you let other people do the work, which often doesn't give them the kind of results that they want. You know, so it's really inspiring to see, you know, young CEOs like you, you know, taste, get your hands dirty.
We have taste.
Unique taste.
So if something doesn't fit into my criteria, I don't take it. I prefer to do it myself, whether he prefers to do it himself, so that he will get the results he wants, as the way he wants it,
as perfect as he wants it to be.
Are you guys, would you consider yourself perfectionist?
No. You can only try to achieve it, or you can never ever get perfection.
Okay. All right. So outside of restaurant business, outside of chefing, because we know you guys are very good cooks.
Yeah.
What else do you like to do? How does Faisal and Fahad spend their time?
I've started to adapt a workout this routine.
Workout routine.
I try to incorporate it to my daily. Sometimes once in a while, I do go to the gym. It helps build my mindset, mentally. You get what I'm saying? And also, you just feel good, you know?
Exactly.
And also aid, in being, handy, You can't be handy if you're not fit.
Exactly. You can see that, yes. Fahad?
I'm more of somebody that, I wouldn't say I'm a workaholic. But my mind is always on business. That's the truth of the matter. I do have my own private life, as I can understand, but it's mostly business.
I like that. Okay, so two more questions before we go.
Sure.
What does the future hold for Fasnet?
You can see multiple, opening multiple
branches.
And then
want to venture into other aspects.
Exactly.
Not just food and cinema. We're thinking of venturing into either spa business, a very good spa, very, you love it, understand?
Okay.
Tailoring.
You'll be surprised. We are also doing our homework there.
I like that.
So going into tailoring, going into spa business, and also real estate.
Watch out for those.
Yeah.
Listen, guys, if there are two young entrepreneurs you should watch out for in Nigeria, we're looking at them right here, Fahad and Faisal. Okay, and they are presently the co-CEOs of Fasnet Cinema, and it's been an amazing interview with the both of you. Thank you very much for bringing us into your private business. Listen, you don't ever get these guys on interviews like this. Almost never. So this is an exclusive from Imaginations. Okay? So on behalf of all our fans, viewers, and young people coming up after you, we say thank you very much.
It's a pleasure, man.
Okay, so we'll go from here. We're going upstairs.
Sure.
To check out the cinema.
Sure.
Are you